Here are three reasons why you need Keyword Explorer. Number one, to discover insights about your audience and how they're searching the content that you're making. Number two, learn about what's trending and the analytics behind it, such as how many videos are out there and whether or not your search phrase is still popular with your audience. Number three, choosing the right target keyword to optimize your videos with. Now that you know, let's learn about Keyword Explorer. So first, there are several different ways that you can open Keyword Explorer. First, you can access Keyword Explorer from the TB extension icon at the top and click Keyword Explorer. The other way, by scrolling down to the bottom, you'll find Keyword Explorer where you can start searching for keywords that you can add directly onto the video. Once you're here, the first page will show you what's currently trending in the country that you select. Now let's start exploring a keyword. Notice that when you start typing a keyword, you'll start seeing related searches right off the bat. If you'd like to use any of these, feel free to click on it. Otherwise, let's hit explore. The next thing you'll notice are two scores, the overall score that is weighted or unweighted. So what's the difference? Weighted will take your channel into account, including your audience. All your channel's profile history will be there to determine whether or not is this keyword relevant for you and your audience. Unweighted is the complete opposite of that, where it won't look at your channel or your audience. It's kind of like throwing a giant net over the sea. You're gonna collect all sorts of viewers, whether or not they might be interested in this topic to begin with or not. Typically, we like to stay in the weighted. So here, we can start looking at our score, and it's really just an indicator to let you know, hey, we found some stuff, take a closer look. So at the bottom is score analysis. This score analysis will give you all the information you need to start making a decision about whether or not this is good for you. We'll see the search volume, which will tell us whether or not there's a lot of it or not. Then there's competition, which will tell us if there's a lot of competition or not. And then there's optimization strength, which tells us whether or not we have a chance of climbing the ranks on YouTube or not so much. We can see the number of videos in search results. We can see an estimate of the number of monthly searches. In case this keyword isn't popular enough, you might see insufficient data here. This just means that there's not enough popularity to determine whether or not you're going to need to allocate a certain amount of resources in order to build that kind of popularity. Last is you versus top ranked videos. This will tell you how difficult it'll be to break into the top ranking search results. Another way to look at this is if I'm not TubeBuddy and I was trying to break into the TubeBuddy scene, then I might have to at least pull in more than 5.73 thousand views. On the right side, we'll see a few different panels starting with YouTube and what that trend looks like over time, not just by 30 days, but by 12 months. And then we'll see all the related searches here. This is a great way to start determining what you might want to use later in the future. If we click on Google, we'll see all the same information except from Google's search results instead. Video Topics is here to help guide you with some video ideas in case you don't have any. This is a great way to start in case you're just building out a brand new channel. Last is Common Tags, which will also give you some data about what is everyone using in order to be discovered. There's another area here, which is the results tab. This will tell you who your biggest competition is going to be according to what is on the top ranking search results at the moment. Notice your keyword highlighted. This is a great way to see what keywords out of your keyword phrase that you're exploring are tying into that search result. Then there's the action menu. Once you've decided that you have found some great keywords to use, there's a few different ways to use this. This is a great way to start a brand new list to save all of the keywords that you've researched that you know you're going to use in your future videos, or perhaps a set of keywords that you might want to add on your current videos. You could also add any of these ideas as a topic in your topic planner, or optimize in SEO Studio if you want to build a draft from here. If you'd like to insert any of the keywords that you are currently searching, click insert into current video or otherwise copy them to a clipboard. When you're selecting a keyword to save in a tag list or a video topic, then make sure to check these boxes for the ones that you want to keep. Then hover over action and select the tag list that you'd like to insert those tags into so that you can use later in your TubeBuddy workflow. Notice those green check marks? Yeah. Now that you're equipped, let's talk about a TubeBuddy workflow combo that you can use. First, use Keyword Explorer to discover all the keyword phrases that you could use for your video. Make sure to select the ones that you've chosen and then add them to a tag list to use in the future. Next, create an SEO Studio draft and import those tags onto your next video. Now get out there and start exploring those keywords, creators. Till next time, catch you later.